We all want things to go faster, well, at least in relation to computing and especially in Blender. A faster GPU is a great way to speed up many tasks in Blender, but let's face it, the past few years hasn't been a good time for buying a graphics card. With things sort of improving, if you are still using a GPU from a time when paying the MSRP was the most you should pay, is it now time to upgrade? Let's find out if a performance increase is worth it. This isn't going to be some in-depth review of multiple GPUs across a mass of test results with dozens of graphs. To start with, I only have two graphics cards. My goal for this video is to provide some performance benchmarks for anyone still using a 5 to 6 year old GPU and wondering what sort of difference a more recent card would make. The test system is a PC I built based on an AMD Ryzen 5900X back in December 2020, while using my old GTX 1070 Ti compared to my recent purchased RTX 3080 Ti. I'll just refer to the GPUs as the 1070 and 3080 for the rest of the video. The computer was running a current release of Windows 10 and the NVIDIA Studio drivers, along with Blender 3.3 at the time of testing. For the scenes to benchmark, I used a few of the most well-known demo files from the Blender website, along with one of my own characters that I'm currently working on. In every case, I made no changes other than to make sure that the GPU was selected, and I switched between CUDA and optics in the preferences. For the render time, I ran the render 3 times in a row, and then used the average for all comparisons. With that all out of the way, let's look at some graphs. We will start with the old classic BMW scene and quickly notice that its 1225 samples with no denoising just isn't the challenge it used to be for modern GPUs. For a bit more of a complete picture, I've included a CPU render for only this scene just to give a bit of a better idea as to why rendering with the GPU is the preferred option. Now the Ryzen 5900X is still a fairly fast CPU, and yet it is over twice as slow as a mid-range GPU released around 3 to 4 years before it. Something to take note, and this will in fact be a constant trend in all of the tests, is that using optics on the 1070 results in a longer render time compared to CUDA. On the other hand, for the 3080 it is reversed, and the optics API, which can take advantage of the ray tracing cores that are present in the 3080, is now always faster. Either way, the 3080 is of course fastest, and comparing the shortest render time of both GPUs, the 3080 is a little over 700% times faster than my old 1070, and a staggering 1500 times percent faster than the Ryzen 5900X. Moving on to the classroom scene, and what is totally not unexpected, we get much the same results for both graphics cards. Once again, the difference between CUDA and optics APIs for both cards is much the same split, while the difference in fastest render times between the two is now a bit under 700%, but not by very much. So, let's have a look at something a little more interesting. The Barcelona scene shows why it is important to test a few different Blender files, as depending on what exactly is being rendered, the results can differ somewhat. While the fastest API for each GPU is still the same, the difference in speed between CUDA and optics on the 1070 is fairly close, especially considering the total render time. However, once you use optics on a card that actually has real ray tracing hardware, such as the 3080, then this scene suddenly renders way faster compared to CUDA on the same GPU. So while demo scenes are nice to test, ideally to get a true idea of any performance gains from a hardware upgrade, it's best to test the content that you are creating. With that in mind, here's a progress render of a character I'm currently working on. Using my old card, render times are basically the same between CUDA and optics. However, yet again, The 3080 is not only significantly faster, but optics is twice as fast compared to using CUDA, giving me a 900% improvement in performance compared to the 1070. So while it was a few years between upgrades, it was at least worth it from a cycle's render point of view. However, what about the viewport and just general usage? This is a bit harder to test, as just using Blender isn't so easy to reproduce on a consistent basis. The best I could come up with was some animation playback. Again, using demo scenes from the Blender website, ball and grass is a simple geometry nodes animation, while Party Tug uses Eevee with a few lanterns swinging back and forth. For proof that sometimes it's not all about the GPU, the grass animation, be it in wireframe or shaded, is totally limited by my CPU. As such, this brings up an important point. Before any upgrade, it pays to identify the bottleneck of what it is you want to improve, just to make sure that what you plan to upgrade will actually have an impact on what you need to go faster. If we look at the Party Tug results, clearly the limiting factor in that case was the GPU, with the 3080 improving the frame rate by nearly 3 times while using the same CPU. Clearly the 3080 is a massive performance boost, but it does use more power, around an extra 200 watts compared to the 1070 for the same final result. By calculating the watt hour for each GPU across all 4 rendered scenes, we can clearly see that while the 3080 averages around 344 watts, its speed just means it is drawing that power for a much shorter amount of time. As such, while the 1070 is only using 144 watts, it actually ends up using more power overall due to processing for a much longer time. Out of interest, I've also included the Ryzen 5900X CPU just for the BMW scene, which at 153, it's a few more watts than the 1070, but of course it takes way longer to render, meaning that if you are able to use a GPU, just about any will likely be a better option compared to the CPU. Now for the obvious question, was it worth it? To answer that, I use the only price that really matters to me, which is what I paid for them. In the case of the 1070, that cost me $829 new around 6 years ago, while the 3080 was also brand new at $1,499, both in Australian dollars. If we divide that cost by the render time, we end up with a cost per second that unsurprisingly is greatly in favour of the 3080 due to its pure speed advantage. Even though it is the most I've ever spent on a GPU, or pretty much any single PC component, the fact that it will allow for much faster production and likely remain useful for the next 10 years means, yes, it was worth it. And with that, I'm going to leave it there. I hope others find this useful in trying to decide if or when a GPU upgrade is needed. If you want to see more or have specific questions or requests, then please click the usual YouTube buttons and or leave a comment below. If not, that's perfectly fine, and I hope to see you for the next one. Cheers.